May I come in, sir?
Ah, please come. आइए.
नमस्कार सर.
Your good name, please.
My name is Subrat Kumar, sir.
हाँ, Subrat. बैठिए.
Thank you, sir.
Subrat, please introduce yourself.
Sir, my name is Subrat Kumar Sahu.
Yeah.
I was born in Ganjam, Odisha.
Yeah.
But I have been living in Bhubaneswar for the last 13 years.
Okay.
And I have completed my 10th and plus 2 in BJM school, Bhubaneswar. And I have completed my graduation in ITR, Soar University, in Bhubaneswar.
Okay. And after that?
Sir, I graduated in 2019 and I have been practicing and studying for civil services for the past 2 years.
Okay. Your subjects?
What are your optional subjects?
Sir, my optional subject is geography and sociology.
Geography and sociology.
Sorry.
With geography of more interest? Geography of Orissa, geography of India?
Sir, I could say both of them, because Odisha is a part of India, so as it encompasses Odisha as well, so I could say it is my interest in India.
More interested in India. So in India we have number of lakes across the country. Can you tell different types of lakes of different origin with one example is?
Sir, one lake is from the mountainous origin. For example, the Wular Lake, that is in North India. And another is the man-made lake, Sardar Sarovar Dam, in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. And another is from the lake that forms from the peninsular rivers, and another one is the formation of brackish water lakes like Chilika Lake. So these are the types of lakes.
Okay. Have you come across the name perennial river, non-perennial rivers?
Yes, sir.
What are those perennial and what are non-perennial?
Sir, perennial rivers are that contain water flow throughout the year. For example, Ganga, and non-perennial years, the non-perennial rivers are the peninsular rivers, for example, Mahanadi, Narmada, Tapi.
So nowadays, because of the climate change,
yes sir,
the glaciers are melting.
Yes sir.
And there is a concept called snow line.
Snow line.
Snow line is changing. What is the snow line?
Sir, according to my opinion, this going back of the Gangotri by 30 kilometers back. So I think that is the concept, something related to the snow line.
And that is going back, obviously, because the glacier ice is melting. So the source of origin of the river Gangotri is shifting towards north. But that is not snow line. Snow line is a general altitude available in the Himalayas up to which the winter snow comes.
Okay, sir.
That is what is snow line. And there is a particular altitude that is about 15,000 feet.
Yes, sir.
But this snow line is also receding, just like
yes,
Gangotri is receding.
Yes, sir.
For climate change, we are using few terms which are coming nowadays, smart energy.
Yes, sir.
What is the smart energy?
Sir,
and how this is related to climate change?
Sir, smart energy is the using of non-renewable energy. Renewable energy such as solar energy, tidal energy, by the use of electronics, and I could not recall the second question.
The question is, the smart energy is linked to climate change.
Yes, sir.
How these are related to each other?
Sir,
You have rightly answered. You can little explore your answer. I think we are getting your answer.
Sir,
you are finding difficulty because are you feeling nervous?
Then no, sir. Like. Sir, this is my first time, so I'm little excited.
You are coming with the right answer.
Sir, the use of solar panels and use of tidal energy and the use of the wind energy.
Okay, we can, if we use a word, E word, I think your answer will be energy which does not pollute and does not lead to climate change.
Yes.
Is this smart energy?
Sir.
You see, you can innovate such type of answers,
okay, sir.
Quick answers and good answers. It can explain everything.
Yes, sir.
There is another word called carbon sink.
Yes, sir.
And there is carbon trading.
Carbon trading, yes, sir.
What this phenomenon?
Sir, carbon sink is the sequestration of carbon by the plantation of trees or afforestation, and also we can use the technology by using the black carbon, collecting the black carbon from the atmosphere and using the technology to sequester deep inside the earth. So, another
carbon trading
is the concept that emerged from the Kyoto Protocol, and if a certain country emits more carbon than the other country, then that country can trade the carbon credits with another country which has surplus carbon points.
You need a little bit of clarity. Also, you are trying to answer that. Okay, clarity is okay. Okay, I think.
Mm-hmm. What is SARC?
SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation.
Where is the headquarters?
Sir, SARC headquarters are at. SARC headquarters are at Nepal, Kathmandu.
What is the difference between the status of President Ladakh and Jammu Kashmir?
Difference of status? Sir, both of them are union territories, and Jammu and Kashmir is vying for a separate statehood, and I don't think Ladakh is expecting a statehood for now, but sorry, sir, nothing is coming to mind.
Which district do you belong?
Sir, I belong to Ganjam district.
Ganjam district. Okay. Ganjam district border ko lagi gote amar lake achi bodhe kon si lake ta
border ko lagi ek lake
chilka lake lagi ni ganjam border ko
sir that is brackish water lake
yes okay another some other names are also given to chilka it's a lake it's a brackish water lake then it's a wetland also. What are other?
Sorry, sir, nothing is coming.
Okay. What is the main river of Ganjam district?
Main river of Ganjam district is Rusikulya.
What are the important towns in Ganjam district?
Important towns are Barampur, Chhatrapur, Ganjam, and Baluga, and Hinjilikot, Aska. And another one is,
what is the main problem of running Aska sugar mill?
Excuse me, sir.
Aska sugar mill is still running or it is closed?
Sir, I am not updated about it.
Okay. Now, you have chosen geography as your optional.
Yes, sir.
Okay. How human geography will be helpful in administration? Why more migration we observe in Ganjam district?
Sir, because lack of economic opportunities, so they are migrating outside the district, and there is limited industries in the Ganjam district, and focus has been only on the agriculture, as it is an agrarian society.
Why Gopalpur beach is famous?
Sir, Gopalpur beach has a history of being a port from medieval times, because the British had opened it as a transportation hub, and now it has been reignited as the Sagarmala policy, and India has been acting on the minor ports also. So I think
as a one important mineral is found in Gopalpur beach. What is that,
sir? These are the rare earth minerals, and that place is called Mattikhalo, and certain rare earth minerals such as I cannot recall it.
Okay, what is the use importance of those minerals?
Sir, those minerals can be used to manufacture. Sorry, those minerals can be used to for the generation of power mainly.
They are radioactive minerals.
Radioactive minerals.
Okay. What are other importance of Ganjam district?
Other importance, sir, it is culturally rich. We have the Danda Nata, and we celebrate also the famous Shivratri also, and in the Ganjam district, Barampur is also known as the Silk City, and it is also famous for the cashew production, and in the Belagunta region, brass metal works are also popular.
Subrato, one is geography, what is the other option?
Sociology.
Yeah. So Subrato, you will make a good civil service officer, but what are the major issues still confronting our economy, our society, particularly in the rural areas?
Sir, the
supposing you become the collector eventually, yes, collector of Ganjam.
Yes, sir.
What would be your thrust areas, priority areas, focus?
Sir, I think that thrust area should be on the women. Because first we need to work for their education, only then they can work upon themselves, on their health, and their socio-economic opportunities. So recently Ganjam has focused on the mushroom production by women farmers. So I think that could be one area which we can work upon. And
You know, the farmers have been agitating in Delhi.
Yes, sir.
Punjab, Haryana,
yes,
Uttar Pradesh.
Yes, sir.
For a long time now.
Yes, sir.
Against the new farm laws.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And so what are your views on that?
Sir, I think it has been a problem that stems from the Green Revolution of the 1960s. So the regional disparity has been created, and as a result the farmers have become richer. So as they have become richer, and
what are the new farm laws, what is the objective of the new farm laws?
Sir, the
to liberalize, to deregulate, isn't it?
Sir, to deregulate and also introduce the contractual farming.
Yes, yes. So why the farmers are objective?
Sir, they are objective.
It's a good objective.
Yes, sir. They are because on paper the government has not declared to make the MSP compulsory. So it has only given a verbal assurance.
What is the difficulty for the government to provide it in the law itself?
Sir, I think India wants to get rid of the subsidy, subsidy problem and reduce its fiscal deficit. I think that could be the
reason. That's why they are.
Yes.
So when the, but Swaminathan committee said, yes, you should give them the support price, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So do you see any anomaly there? And our farmers asking for minimum guarantee. So what is the via media?
Excuse me, sir.
What is the middle ground?
Sir, I think the farmers should be empowered in such a way that they will no longer ask for MSP. So they will be self-sufficient and steps should be taken such that agriculture is made an enterprise. So that could be the solution.
Very good, Subrat. So what do you feel? What is your performance?
Sir, I think I am lacking in clarity and some areas on the static part.
On the what?
Static portion.
Okay.
Sir, can I ask what are your hobbies?
Sir, my hobby is writing blogs and sometimes I collect e-waste as well.
E-waste,
electronic waste.
Electronic waste, yes. You collect?
Yes.
What for?
Sir, in 2000 actually, Bhubaneswar came up with an initiative of Clean E-Bhubaneswar. So I was inspired by that initiative, so I started collecting it.
Okay.
So I called them and they said that we only collect in bulk and we do not collect from private houses and residential houses. So we can only take up to if the total kilos is up to 20 kilo, then we will come to your home and we will take your e-waste. So by that time I have collected 20 kilos. That initiative closed down. So I still continue to collect from my friends also.
Okay, okay.
So in the future, if I go to Bhopal, where there is an e-waste facility, I will donate it.
Okay. What is the use of this e-waste?
Sir,
how is it recycled?
Sir, the e-waste collected can be recycled for getting gold, silver, and various other precious metals. So these has been recently used in the Tokyo Olympic Games as for making the medals. So that can
all our e-waste is carrying gold.
No sir, some are carrying, and also another like aluminium also is available.
Okay sir, I think he's all right. He himself is a little skeptic, otherwise.
What are your inspirations? Who are your role models?
Sir, role model, I would say my grandfather and my father.
Okay.
Yes, sir, my grandfather was the first bank account holder in our village.
Okay.
And so he was very much futuristic.
Okay.
So I take inspiration from
him. And your father?
My father was the first bank officer from our village.
Which bank?
State Bank of India.
Okay. And in public life, public figures?
Sir, in public figures, from my grandfather's side, a distant relative, he was the...
No, I mean at the national levels and...
Sir, in the state level there was. Sir, he was the two-time MLA from Chhatrapur constituency.
Okay. Among the freedom fighters in those days, historical figures,
yes, sir.
Spiritual.
Sir,
who are your models?
From our Ganjam district, during the civil disobedience movement.
No, you need not confine yourself to Ganjam. I am talking at the national level. Who are your inspiration that way?
Sir, I take inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi.
So
the ideals of cleanliness and punctuality are the defining factors for me.
Okay. Very good, Siddhartha. You're a young man. How old are you?
Sir, I just turned 24 in August.
Okay. Good. You have the potential, Siddhartha. You have the potential. Some of the answers you gave, I was impressed by the answer when you said you take the carbon and then take it deep into the earth. I was impressed because that's something I have not.
Gave some good answers.
Good answers, and even the initiative, e-waste and all, it's all totally new things there. Yes, so you think out of the box, and then where you are going to, you have a good understanding. Yes, but and maybe as the interview progress, you are becoming slightly nervous and then losing confidence. Never lose confidence. Okay? Yes. Yeah, never lose confidence, and I'm sure there is a lot of, you see, even the e-waste, I think, by accidentally we discover.
Yes, we discovered.
Yeah.
We got your, you have that in talent, but we discovered that.
It should be, on the other hand, you should be, this is a personality test. It's not a test on chemistry, agriculture, yes, geography, or sociology.
Yes, sir.
These are all only the, I mean, balls thrown at you. Yes. It is for you to how you're utilizing the ball. Some you defend, some you say you have to score. Yes, and sir, good balls. I mean, I was impressed by the carbon, this thing. You said it's not only afforestation you create, but even the one that is there, you just use the technology, invent the technology, and suck it into the earth.
Yes,
I had not heard, honestly, I had not heard it before, so I was impressed. So, and then your own thing is initiative, e-waste, and then that is again out of the way. So you are pioneering.
Yes.
You are not on the beaten track. These are all very, very important clues to your personality. But then you have to be looking for, you should not feel shy or modest.
Yes.
You should be eager. These are my, you must first of all discover your personality.
Yes.
It's a competitive examination.
Yes.
You must discover your personality. What are my strengths?
Yes.
What are my strengths?
Sir, my strength would be the ability to listen.
Like that. So you must be aware of your strong points and then look for opportunities, be alert, and then put out your personality. Help the board, bring forth your personality without being very arrogant about it. That's a whole trick, okay?
Yes.
You should not, withdraw. You should not go, okay? Any other thing you'd like to ask of us?
No, sir, I'm fine.
But you are not very smilingly staring at us, not actually in a normal mood to have eye contact with us.
Remember, you give the impression of a very bright college student. You get the point. Because you are very young and so you should impress us. Yes, here is the future collector of Ganjam,
yes,
or superintendent of police. Incidentally, police is a choice or not?
Yes, sir.
Fourth choice?
No, second choice.
Okay. So that is it. So we are looking for the future superintendent of police, future collectors.
Yes.
You get the point. So that should be, you should get into that frame of mind. No longer a PG student or that kind of this. Okay? And any other, similarly the form law and all, I think you came to the point. In fact, you arrived at the issue. Government cannot give because they no longer want the subsidy burden,
yes,
which is a point for the first time it is coming in today's this thing.
Okay.
So you have all the points. Only thing is you are hesitant, you are withdrawing, you are refusing to come out.
Sir. So what shall I do?
Question: practice.
Yes.
When is your interview?
It's around 30th.
30th. Oh, a lot of time is there.
Yes, sir.
In fact, some of the answers you give are really first-class answers, the best answers,
yes,
on the issue. Particularly the carbon issue and even the farmers issue. You were the one to say government does not want to commit itself to MSP.
Yes,
that point did not come forth.
Yes.
Not to derogate from the rest of the government. This, but though you should be aware,
yes,
but this hesitancy, uncertainty, yes, have your point of view. It's quite possible there may be another point of view, equally valid.
Yes.
There's no right or wrong answers in humanities.
Yes,
science, yes. Pluto is not the point. But in humanities, humans, there is no right or wrong answers. Which is good, communism as a tenet or capitalism? There is no answer to that. There are, because there are communist countries still, there are capitalist countries still, and there is a blend. So there are multiple points, black, white, grey areas, they coexist, equally valid.
Yes.
But it all depends whether you have a view. Do you have a view in the first place? And if you have a view, are you able to rationalize, so defend it?
Yes.
That conviction. Once you have a conviction, then the courage of it, to politely defend it. Okay, that if you practice, it will come. All the best, Siddhartha. God bless you.
Sir, about my dressing sense and...
Dressing is okay. Fine.
Everything is okay. Only thing is you modulate your facial and eye contacts.
Yes.
Okay. Body language is okay. Give a little smile in between.
Yes.
By not smiling, what happens? No, it seems like you are thinking.
Mm.
You don't want to be aggressive in our questions and answers. So little,
and
it must look smart.
Correct. And
like
if you are comfortable putting on a, are you comfortable in a suit?
No, sir.
No, don't. This is fine.
This is
okay.
Fine.
This is fine.
Okay.
Any other question?
No, sir. No, no more questions.
But you look still doubtful and hesitant. Something in your mind. Have a free mind.
Relax yourself. Think that you are moving in a train, there are some co-passengers here and you are with them, getting engaged.
And being a first interviewer, you should enjoy. I remember first time, though I did not get good marks, but I really enjoyed my, because at that time I was young and then, so I didn't know the formality, etc. Not that I scored, but then I made it to your service, but the point is, you should relax at some stage. Initially, yes, some nervousness, some tension will be there, but quickly you should settle down and then gain your poise. See, you must be polite, respectful of the panel. No, there's no doubt about it. But it doesn't mean that you become in awe. Don't be overawed by the people because they are aged, experienced. They will know more. But that should not overawe you. You should not be overawed because we were all like you. When we go for an, when at your age, when we were also like this, so that should be there.
Sir, about my voice, the modulation is it's all right?
Okay, it can be a little louder.
And be comfortable, be sit, so that you become self-assurance. Remember, you're going to be an officer, a very, very responsible officer, playing a critical role in the district administration. So, imagine yourself, visualize yourself. You are an officer. This is not a college.
Yes.
Okay. So, that quiet assurance should be there. Very polite, very alert, intently listening to what they say, and then take time, pause, but all the time at your ease. You should be absolutely at ease, not nervous at all. Because if you are nervous, then you are not able to think and then on the spot, think on your feet, as they say. No. Factual question, if you do not know, no way you can answer, leave them. But conceptually, issues like this thing, you must be. Okay? All the best.
Thank you, sir.
You'll do well. Okay? God bless you.